Would you believe it was the Revolutionary War? It's the only war, non-war modern era that lasted longer than 4 years, and it lasted the same length as the Vietnam War, about 8.5 years. So the official number of wounded in Iraq was 32,000. Now it turns out that the military does not have a very good way of keeping track of the number of wounded, and the number is actually closer to something like 100,000. In addition to the 4,500 people killed. A terrible number is that in the U.S. today there are 360,000 former service men and women living with brain injuries, traumatic brain injury. And about 90,000 of those are severe enough that it impacts their lives and the lives of their families on a continuing, ongoing basis. And I know what that's like. I have a nephew who has a traumatic brain injury, and it has destroyed his life and destroyed the life of his family. It's taken him, effectively taken him away from his family. That's a terrible thing. And this is one of the severe injuries that doesn't get a lot of publicity. You hear a lot about guys who lost arms and legs, and that's a terrible thing to have happen. But we don't hear enough, I don't think, about the impact of traumatic brain injury on our returning service people. I read something else interesting this morning. There have been 42,000 Vietnamese killed in Vietnam since the end of the Vietnamese War by unexploded ordnance that exploded. The estimate is that there's 350 tons of unexploded ordnance left in Vietnam. That's about 20 Hiroshimas waiting to go off. And so the question is, how many more innocent Vietnamese are going to die because we were there for 8.5 years and accomplished nothing but killing Americans and killing Vietnamese? The Department of Defense budget for 2012 is $707 billion.
Whoa.
Now that sounds like a big number, except that doesn't tell the whole story. The whole story, if you add in FBI monitoring, Homeland Security, Veterans Administration, and all of the other costs spent by other agencies on defense and war is $1.4 trillion. That's $4,000 for every man, woman, and child in the United States that's going to be spent in 2012 for war and defense. And that's given to where we need to be spending our money. That just makes absolutely no sense. Absolutely no sense. And what we're worried about is Big Bird. I mean, for God's sake, when that kind of money is being spent, and we're worried about that tiny percentage of, and this is not a political statement, it's just, who cares? Why are we focused there? Why aren't we focused on the money we're spending on war and on the men and women? Not only our own citizens, but the citizens of the other countries that are being devastated by wars. The real problem is you and I, for the most part, have no connection to what's going on in Afghanistan. I don't know anyone who's been injured in Afghanistan and died in Afghanistan. I don't know anyone who was injured or died in Iraq. It's something that those people do, and it doesn't affect the vast majority of us. It may have affected someone here, but certainly not all of us here. Our wars are now fought by somebody else, and so most of the American public basically doesn't give a damn. It's just something that governments do. They go off and fight, and we applaud our servicemen when they come home, and then we don't really take care of them very well after they get back. That's really all I want to say, except that as Veterans of Peace mission states, we have simply got to stop using war as an element of national policy. It makes no sense for any of us.